Hello. In this video, we will cover various network devices. Network devices are various hardware devices that are used to connect computers, printers, etc. to a network. They are also called as networking hardware, networking equipment, etc. These devices help to transfer data in a fast, secure, and correct way over same or different networks. Each of these devices have a specific purpose. Let's look at some of them over here. For any machine to connect to network, it first needs a network interface card or Wi-Fi card. Network interface card or NIC is also known as Ethernet card, network card, LAN card, network adapter, or sometimes network adapter card, network interface card, or a terminal access point. It is a physical and data link layer device used by computers to connect to Ethernet LAN and communicate with other devices on the LAN. The earliest Ethernet cards were external to the system and needed to be installed manually. In modern computer systems, it is an internal hardware component. The NIC manufacturer assigns a unique physical address to each NIC card. This physical address is called as MAC address or Media Access Control address. The MAC address is a 6-byte unique hardware identification number that uniquely identifies each device on a network. Because there are millions of networkable devices in existence, MAC address helps to distinguish them on the network. Wi-Fi card is a card used to connect any device to the local network wirelessly. Wi-Fi is the acronym for wireless fidelity. Wi-Fi technology is used to achieve wireless connection to any network. They have built-in wireless radio and antenna. Most common card is the PIC Express Wi-Fi card. It is very useful if you do not have hardline network access available. We have Wi-Fi access points, which is the physical area of the network which provides internet access through Wi-Fi. It is also called as Wi-Fi hotspot. Hotspots can be set up at home, office, or any public space. Hotspots themselves are connected to the network through wires. Every access point has a range of around 120 to 150 feet for home or much larger for school or university, and only devices within this range can connect to network. There can also be a limit of number of computing devices that can connect to the network. So with NIC or Wi-Fi card, your device is ready to talk to other devices. Now you need either hub, switch, or router to connect to other computers. Hub is a physical layer device which has multiple ports that are used to connect multiple computers or segments of LAN together. The data is transferred in packets to entire computer network. So when a host sends a data packet to a network hub, the hub copies the data packet to all of the ports it is connected to. Like this, all the ports know about the data, and the port for whom the packet is intended claims the packet. Hubs can be passive or active. Passive hub allow the signal to be passed without any change. Active hub amplify the signal as it moves from one device to another. That helps to extend the range of the network without using repeaters. Disadvantages of hub is that because of its working mechanism, a hub is not so secure and safe. Moreover, copying the data packets on all the interfaces or ports makes it slower and more congested, which led to the use of network switch. Switch is more intelligent than a hub. While hub just does the work of data forwarding, a switch does filter and forwarding. which is more intelligent way of dealing with the data packets. So when a packet is received at one of the interfaces of the switch, it checks the destination address and transmits the packet to the correct receiver. Before forwarding, the packets are checked for collision and other network errors too. This technique is called packet switching technique. The switch also maintains a list of network addresses of all the devices connected to it. In this way, it helps to prevent traffic overloading in LAN. Next is router, which is the smartest or most complicated of the three. Router is mainly a network layer device. It can work like a switch that routes data packets based on their IP addresses. It also maintains a dynamically updating routing table based upon which they make decision on routing the data packets. What it does more than the switch is connecting multiple different networks together. Router normally connects LANs with internet or other WANs together. It has the capability to repackage the data and send over another network. Many times you would be asked to differentiate between hub, switch, and router. So let's go over some of the points here. A hub works in physical layer of OSI model, while switch works on data network layer. Router works on network layer of OSI model. Hub broadcasts messages, while switch multicast messages. Router actually routes messages. Hub sends data in bits, switch sends data in frames, and router sends data as packets. Hub is used to connect devices within the same network. Switch is used to connect devices to network, while router is used to connect two different networks. Hub does not store MAC address locally, while both switch and router does store the addresses. For connecting between different networks, we also use bridge and gateways. A bridge connects two or more LANs. It operates at data link layer. Bridge can handle networks that follow the same protocol only. Like a hub, a modern bridge has multiple ports, but unlike hub, when a frame arrives, the bridge extracts the destination address from the frame header and looks it up in a table to see where to send the frame. A bridge only outputs the frame on the port where it is needed and can forward multiple frames at the same time. So filtering, forwarding, and blocking of frames are function of bridges. Now the gateway is a network device used to connect two or more dissimilar networks, that is, networks that use different protocols. It establishes an intelligent connection between the local network and an external network. A gateway usually is a computer with multiple NICs connected to different networks. For a large enterprise, this computer can also act as a proxy server, firewall, or malware protection. In addition, some networks also need repeaters. Repeaters are used to extend the transmission so that the signal can cover longer distances or be received on the other side of an obstruction. It increases the power of a signal and retransmits it. To watch more videos like this, you can visit my website simplycoding.in for more details. Goodbye.